Hello, I'm Edward Tarte, math teacher. This is another in my series of solution videos for some of my math challenges. The challenge for this video is my square root challenge. Here is how I introduced that challenge in the original video. Finding the square root of a square number. 5,329 is a square number. How to find its square root step by step. Here is the square root notation. And I write 5,329 this way. The last two numerals in a group, the two numerals before that in a group also. We begin with 53. 53 is not a square number. We look for the largest square smaller than 53. Our choice is 7 times 7. I put the 7 here above the 53. 7 squared, that is 7 times 7, is 49. I write that below the 53. I draw a line and subtract. 53 minus 49 is 4. You can see that this bears a resemblance to long division, except there is no divisor. Having subtracted and gotten 4, I bring down the 29. So now I have 429. Now I'm going to do something mysterious. I need a divisor. To get it, I'm going to double the 7. That is, multiply it by 2. 7 times 2 is 14. I write the 14 here, but I leave room for another numeral, and I'm going to do something else mysterious. I'm going to figure out a numeral to go here and put the same numeral here above the 29 so that 140 something times this same numeral will fit here. 3 will work. I will put a 3 here and the same number 3 here. 143 times 3 is 429. And there you have it. The square root of 5,329 is 73. And we can easily verify that 73 times 73 actually does equal 5,329. And now, your challenge. In my earlier video on square numbers, at the end of the video, I illuminated the arithmetic by a geometric interpretation. That is, I showed how geometry can clarify and explain the arithmetic so that it all makes sense. My challenge to you here is basically the same thing with this. Find a geometric interpretation which clarifies and illuminates what you see here, especially the mysterious part to which I have alluded, doubling the 7 to get 14, and then putting the same numeral here and here. I know that geometric interpretation. I discovered it myself. I challenge you to discover it. Here's my solution, my geometric interpretation of the square root algorithm, specifically of the problem in the challenge, finding the square root of 5,329. As in the challenge, the first step is to put a 7 up here, and 7 squared is 49. Subtracting, we get 4, then we bring down the 29. That 7 represents a square 70 by 70, which has an area of 4,900. Now we have the mysterious part of the process where I double the 7, making 14, and I put that box after the 14 for an unknown numeral, and the same numeral will go up at the top alongside the 7. What we have here is 429 square units left over, and they have to be positioned with the 70 by 70 square to form a slightly larger square. They will be in this L shape that I have here, from here to here. That L shape consists of a narrow rectangle 70 by some unknown number X, another thin rectangle just like it, also 70 by X, plus this little square in the corner to complete the total square, that little square being X units by X units. What we have here is 140x plus x times x, and that is summarized here. X turns out to be 3 in this problem. What this represents with the 3 in both boxes is 70 times 3, that's one of the narrow rectangles, plus another 70 times 3, that's the other narrow rectangle, plus 3 times 3, which is the little square in the corner. 70 times 3 plus another 70 times 3 plus 3 times 3 is 143 times 3, which is 429, which places the remaining 429 square units in this L shape to complete the square. So that is my geometric interpretation of the square root algorithm, specifically of the square root of 5,329. Thank you for watching this solution video.